We have good sound effects. Give him your air horn.
Should I?
Beautiful, Tracy. Beautiful.
Okay, I'm thinking you might hear it.
We have the opening.
It's not so much that we wanted to fill a space, we wanted to create a space that wasn't there before.
A lot of podcasters tend to come from the same places, same universities, same like NPR style training. So it all kind of also tends to sound uniform. And like Ira Glass is their god.
I saw a comic once, a cartoon, and it was like a foot race between white folks. You had a white person in this lane and then a black person in this lane. And it's like, you know, you have the same start as everyone else, blah, 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 blah. But in the black person's lane, there's like alligators and barbed wire. We have to be like the right kind of black for people to pay attention to us. You know, we can't make white people too uncomfortable when we talk about race. And that's exhausting. It is exhausting to have to pick and choose.
I do not have the energy for that.
Yeah, we have so much going on.
We have a life to live. Appealing to white people's consciousness has a rough history in America, but appealing to capitalism does well. Hence, I like to make the diversity argument about larger markets, mm-hmm. untapped audiences. Mm-hmm. There are swaths of people you're not reaching. So if you are just not here for the moral reasons,
then be here for the money.
Yes.
As black women, we know what it feels like to be overlooked and ignored. And we were finally like, hey, we have the microphone.
We want this to be a space. All of it is on our mm-hmm. terms.
Yeah.
We can have conversations with people like even like Hillary Clinton and mm-hmm. have it be on our terms.
Ben Smith, our editor in chief, really like encouraged us to like ask her the things that we really, really wanted to know. That he was like, you know, you'll probably never interview her again. You know, you're not trying to make a best friend. So, you know, who cares if she gets uncomfortable? She had to meet us where we were, you know, and we talked to her the same way we talked to everybody else. We were like, you're in our house, hill.
We didn't say that.
No, we didn't at all. It feels amazing to not have to be someone's diversity coach.
Or just feels so good. Filter all your thoughts about culture through the prism of like one very specific outlook.
Yeah. And just like not having to worry, like, what are white people gonna think? Ooh. Who cares? If this show doesn't make the right sort of space for like the general white person to listen to, they can go literally anywhere else and find something
like
made just for them. 97%
of podcasts. Y'all got a lot of stuff.
Yes.
My name is Heben Nigatu.
I'm Tracy Clayton.
And this is our brief but spectacular take on
being unapologetically black.